And I heard, I heard even more ridiculous, I hope it's not true, but I heard that SASB was asked by the federal ministers to help bear the repairing and maintenance costs for these IPPs. And I want, and I urge the Sabah government to initiate an investigation on this claim. Why should SASB pay for the IPP maintenance and repairs when SASB has already been paying high prices for the electricity supply? I urge the state government to make sure that SASB doesn't pay for IPP maintenance and repairs, and instead, I proposed that Sabah government to help SASB take over these power plants due to the breach of contractual obligations by the IPPs. Take over them. Sabah government should look into seriously assisting SASB to own more power plants as action plans to gradually work towards lower electricity tariff for general Sabahans, while the SASB can make reasonable profit. So if SASB doesn't have the financial strength to do it, federal government should give grants, or the state government can jointly invest in different power plants through the government agencies and own them with SASB. I propose to revive the Yayasan Amana Saham Rakyat Sabah to pump in money into viable projects and viable utility business entities to make money and also to give back to Sabah in a form of dividends. We can revive that Amana Saham. Bottom line is, the TNB is not sincere in helping Sabah. That is the bottom line. We must help ourselves to acquire SASB, and Sabah government must help us. Sabah government needs to help Sabahans by initiating takeover of SASB. Hopefully now.